We're going to code an ICD-10-CM scenario where we need to use the table of drugs and chemicals to look up our code. So first, I'm going to read our scenario. The patient was seen for treatment of a fine rash that had developed on the patient's trunk and upper extremities over the last 3 to 4 days. The patient was diagnosed with hypertension 7 days ago and started on rampopril 10 milligrams daily. The physician determined the rash to be dermatitis due to the rampopril. The rampopril was discontinued and the patient was prescribed a new antihypertensive medication, captopril. In addition, the physician prescribed a topical cream for the localized dermatitis. What diagnosis codes are assigned? First, we need to determine what our principal diagnosis is. In this case, it's the rash, which is called dermatitis in medical terminology, and I'm sure you learned that in your medical terminology class and reviewed it in some of your other classes. So I'm going to start by going to my alphabetical index, and I'm going to look up dermatitis. And I found dermatitis, and I'm going through, and I found a section labeled due to. So I go down that list, and I'm looking for something related to drugs, since that's what caused the dermatitis. I found drugs and medicaments, which has a code of L27.0. But I'm going to go ahead and look down this list underneath it, and I find a code for localized skin eruption. And that's what happened with the dermatitis with the rash. And it gives me a more specific code of AL27.1, which is in the same general area of the first code that I found. So I'm going to go to that section of the tabular list and verify my code. So I'm going to find L27. And L27 is for dermatitis due to substances taken internally. I'm going to take a quick look at these excludes one and excludes two notes, and none of them apply. I'm going to go down and look at L27.1, and it's for localized skin eruption due to drugs and medicaments taken internally. I'm going to glance through these other codes, and that one does make the most sense because the one above it is a generalized skin eruption, and this dermatitis was only on his trunk and upper extremities. So L27.1 is our correct code for the principal diagnosis. I see an instructional note under that. It states, use additional code for adverse effect, if applicable, to identify drug, and then in parentheses, T36 to T50 with fifth or sixth character S. So I need to look at the drugs and chemicals table in order to identify the code to use. So I'm going to go back to the drugs and chemicals table. It is shortly after the alphabetical index. I find the alphabetical index, then the neoplasm table, and then I find the table of drugs and chemicals. So I'm going to look for the drug rampopril, since that is what caused the dermatitis. I'm going to go to the R listing of the drugs, and I found the drug rampopril. I see a number of columns in the drug and chemicals table. There's columns for accidental poisoning, intentional poisoning, assault, undetermined, adverse effects, or underdosing. This particular one was an adverse effect of a drug given correctly. So I'm going to use that column, and it's the second to the last column, and with rampopril, the code is T46.4X5. Now I'm going to go to the code in the tabular list and verify it. And I found it here. It's adverse effect of angiotensin convertive enzyme inhibitors, and that is another hypertensive drug that the patient had initially. And when I look at that code, I see a little red check mark next to it. And that means that I need another character for this code to be complete. So I'm going to go up to the top of the T46 section and find the list of seventh characters that are available to me to use. And this states, the appropriate seventh character is to be added to each code from category T46. My choices are A, initial encounter, D, subsequent encounter, and S, sequela. Sequela is the term for late effects in ICD-10. This was the initial encounter for this visit for the patient. So I'm going to add an A as the seventh character. So my complete code is T46.4X5A. I have one more code to look up. In the scenario, this patient has hypertension. I need to code that hypertension because it is impacting his treatment for this visit since they're looking at the drugs he's taking for that. So I need to go back to the alphabetical index and I'm going to look up hypertension. And I found hypertension. The code for hypertension without any additional conditions associated with it is I10. And I have no more information other than he has hypertension. So that's the code that I want. I don't want any of these subterms under it. So I'm going to verify this in the tabular list. I'm going to the I section and find I10. And I10 is for essential primary hypertension. I'm going to glance through the includes, excludes 1, and excludes 2 notes under that, and none of those relate to his hypertension. So I10 by itself is the correct code in this case. There's no additional characters needed. So now I've completed coding this scenario. I have 3 codes. They are L27.1, T46.4X5A, and I10. And that completes coding this scenario.